Hello, hi my dear friends, welcome to my channel HSR by Info. Today we are going to discuss one more important organelle of the plant, that is plastids. Actually we have somewhat discussed in the previous class. In the present class we are going to discuss about the chloroplast, especially in detailed manner. Let us start with the chloroplast. Actually, we know very well the chloroplast is a plant material which is very essential for the photosynthesis. Then what is the photosynthesis? All the things regarding to the photosynthesis I will discuss in the next session. So let us start with the chloroplast structure and the number and also different shapes of chloroplast in the present class. Okay, the photosynthesis can be done by the chloroplast. Actually, this chloroplast initially identified by a scientist called as Antoni von Leeuwenhoek. Antoni von Leeuwenhoek is a scientist. He identified chloroplast. Okay, now coming to the, what is the shape of chloroplast? Is there only single shape or any variation in the shapes of chloroplast, and what is the number of chloroplast in each cell? Is there only a constant number is maintaining in the all the animal kingdom and also plant kingdom? So there is any variation in the number of chloroplast which are present in a cell? That should be how to know. So let us start with the a table that showing see organism number of chloroplast per cell and shape. And shape. So let us start with the Chlamydomonas. Chlamydomonas is an organism that contains one chlorophyll per cell. One chlorophyll or chloroplast per cell. And coming to the shape, the shape here, the cup shape and horseshoe shape. The second organism is Eulotheria. This is also contains one chloroplast per cell and it has a girdle shape or C shape. And the third one is the Spirogyra. This Spirogyra that contains 1 to 16 chloroplast per cell. It has a ribbon like chloroplast shape. Coming to the fourth, all higher plants. All higher plants that contains 20 to 40 chloroplast per cell. It has a shape oval or discoid. So this table is very important for the neat purpose. Here this table showing number of chloroplast per cell. A cell that contains a different number of chloroplast and in the different organisms, and the shape also vary from one organism to the another organism. Okay, this is clear. So let us start with the how these shapes are present. See, for example, here is a Chlamydomonas. The Chlamydomonas is looking like this. This Chlamydomonas that contains the chloroplast 1 in cup shape. See, let us see, this is like in this way, it is looking this chloroplast present like this. This is a cup shape. Okay. This is a Chlamydomonas. Coming to the Eulotheria. Eulotheria also that is present. Like this. This Eulotheria actually that present as a giddy chloroplast or C-shaped chloroplast. Let us see. Like this. This is a C-shape in this way. In this way, it contains the in each cell. Okay, this is called a C-shape. Coming to the Spirogyra. Spirogyra, it is a filamentous structure. This filamentous structure that contains chloroplast in a ribbon structure. Let us start with this. So this is a ribbon like structure. Okay. This is chloroplast, here is a chloroplast, here is a chloroplast, different shape, here is a cup shape, here is a C shape, here is a ribbon like structure. Okay, this is all about the different kinds of chloroplast which are present in different organisms and also different in number. Let us start with the our chloroplast, that is the higher plants that contains the chloroplast in a oval or discoid shape. We have to see this shape in a detailed manner. Okay, let us start with that. Okay, chloroplast that has a double membrane structure. Double membrane structure. The outside membrane we call as the outer membrane. Coming to the one more membrane, that is the inner membrane. Inner membrane. This inner membrane we call as a simply inner membrane. Inner membrane. Again, see this inner membrane that is extended to the empty space that is present in the chloroplast. Empty space. That empty space we called as a chloroplast stroma. Chloroplast stroma. Whereas in the mitochondria, the empty space we called as a matrix. Okay, that should be remembered. Stroma is present in the chloroplast, whereas matrix that is present in the mitochondria. Here, these chloroplasts, the inner membrane infold into, extended into the inside, and also this extension get forms into different discoidal structure on each other. One on each other. So this type of discoidal structure or sac-like structure which are stay on one another, that is called as a grana. Here the single, the complete this structure, the complete this structure we called as a grana, whereas The single discoidal structure or single sac like structure we called as a thylakoid. So these thylakoid that extends into inside again, and again it forms grana thylakoids. Again it forms another grana thylakoid. Again it is also connected with the so in this way it is forming grana in the middle of the stroma. In the middle of the stroma, it is not like in straight manner, there is also looking like this. It may be like this. So in this way, it's showing the different granas in the stroma of chloroplast. Now let us see the grana that is interconnected by the single sac like structure that is called as a grana lamella. Grana lamella. Okay, this is the structure of chloroplast which is exclusively present in the higher plants. Okay, the stroma, coming to the each and every part, you have to see what are the components which are present in the stroma and what are the components which are present in the thylakoids. Okay, let us see. The stroma actually contains many enzymes. This is the stroma, the empty space which are present in the chloroplast is called as a stroma. The stroma, let us see here, the stroma, the empty space which are present in the chloroplast. Now the stroma that contains the many enzymes, many enzymes. The best example for this enzyme is Arabisco. Okay, I will discuss Rubisco function in the next to photosynthesis class. So here, this is a Rubisco is an enzyme which is most abundantly presented protein or enzyme in the world. In the universe, the most abundantly presenting enzyme or protein is a Rubisco. This is a very peculiar point to be noted. So this Rubisco which is present in the stroma of chloroplast. Again, this stroma which is essential for the dark reaction. Dark reaction. Actually, the photosynthesis can occur in two forms, two stages. In this, one stage is the light reaction, second stage is the dark reaction. Such second dark reaction can occur in the stroma of chloroplast. This stroma also contains ribosomes. Ribosomes, especially 70S ribosomes. Along with the cytoplasmic ribosomes which are present in the cell of plant, these chloroplast also contain its own ribosome. The ribosomes are the 70S, whereas cytoplasmic ribosomes are the 80S ribosomes. Coming to the DNA. DNA also which is present in the stroma. The DNA which is present in the stroma is a double-stranded circular. Double-stranded circular DNA. Okay, again this stroma, in this stroma the protein synthesis will occur. Protein synthesis will occur. Actually, see, due to the presence of DNA and also presence of ribosomes, these organelles individually synthesizing its own proteins. But it is also depend on the nuclear DNA. Nuclear DNA for the many proteins which are essential for the formation of the chloroplast. That's why these chloroplasts also we called as a semi-autonomous. Semi-autonomous organelle, which is also similar to the mitochondria. Okay, semi-autonomous organelle. This is all about the stroma. Coming to the this thylakoid. Actually, thylakoids that contains chlorophyll. Chlorophyll, it's a pigment. Actually, the chlorophyll is a greenish color. This greenish color which is present in the these thylakoids, that's why these thylakoids looking like green in color. So thylakoid that contains the chlorophylls. Again, these thylakoids also contain the carotenoids. Xanthophylls. And phycobilins. Okay, these are all are the pigments. The chlorophyll is the main pigment, whereas carotenoids, xanthophylls, and the phycobilins are the accessory pigments. That should be remembered. What are the accessory pigments which are present in the thylakoid? That means the carotenoids, xanthophylls, phycobilins are the accessory pigments. And whereas the main pigment for the thylakoid is the chlorophyll. Okay. Now, this thylakoid that is very essential for the light reaction. I already mentioned the photosynthesis that occurs in two stages, light reaction, dark reaction. The dark reaction that occurred in the stroma of chloroplast, whereas light reaction that occurring in the thylakoid of the chloroplast. Is it clear? This is regarding to the thylakoid. Okay. Okay, this is all about the structure of thylakoid. Here, one point to be noted, outer membrane that is present as a rich amount of lipids and low amount of proteins. And due to the presence of this structure, which allows the all the substances, all the moieties which are present in the cytoplasm of the plant cell. Now, the inner membrane is impermeable to the all substances. It is selectively permeable. It is selectively permeable in nature because it contains the high in protein, low in lipids. We know very well the plasma membrane, any membrane that contains are made up of with the lipoprotein. That's why here you have to remember, here I mentioned lipid and protein. Both we called as a lipoproteins. If the lipids and proteins that are present in the membrane, that is called as a lipoprotein. Okay, clear? This is all about the structure of chloroplast and where actually chlorophyll is present, what is the function of stroma and etc. Okay. Now, we have to see the endosymbiotic theory of chloroplast. And also, we have to see the similarities which are present in bacteria and mitochondria and chloroplast. Let us start with the endosymbiotic theory. Endosymbiotic theory. Actually, the present eukaryotic cells, which are came from the already existed prokaryotic cells or aerobic cells and also photosynthetically active cells. There are the three types of cells you have to remember here. In the initial stage is the primitive stage of universe and where actually there is a cell. This cell we called as a eukaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell. Along with the eukaryotic cell, across the eukaryotic cell, around the eukaryotic cell, there is also one more cells are present, that is a photosynthetically active cell. This is a photosynthetically active cell. Due to the presence of chlorophyll or chloroplast, these cells are showing the photosynthesis. Okay, this eukaryotic cell. Again, beside that, one more cell is there. That cell is a aerobic respiratory active cell. The cell that showing the, that performing the aerobic respiration. Now, let us see, this eukaryotic cell is engulfed to the photosynthetically active cell. Actually, this photosynthetically active cell that is enter into the this eukaryotic cell. Again, the aerobic respiratory active cell that is also enter into the these eukaryotic cells. After some years, after many years, this eukaryotic cell that converted into the complete eukaryotic cell that containing chloroplast and also mitochondria. Chloroplast and mitochondria. Here, this is all about the endosymbiotic theory. Aerobic respiratory active cells that is enter into the eukaryotic cell and also photosynthetically active cell that enter into the eukaryotic cells. After long period of time, all these aerobic respiratory active cells that converted into the this one, that is the mitochondria, photosynthetically active cells that enter into the eukaryotic cell for a long time after that converted into the chloroplast. In this way, the plant cell can evolve. The plant cell can evolve. So, this is all about the endosymbiotic theory of eukaryotic cell. The eukaryotic cell that contains the DNA in the middle of cell. Actually, eukaryotic plant cell that contains the nucleus at the side of the cell. So, this is the plant cell that contains the chlorophyll and also mitochondria, which is came from the aerobic organism and also photosynthetically active organism. Okay, this is all about the endosymbiotic theory, how actually chloroplast is evolved from the evolutionary times. Okay, is it clear? Now, let us see the what are the differences. Why we are mentioning these prokaryotic cells are very responsible for the formation of the eukaryotic cells. That is the concept of endosymbiotic theory. Due to this, some similarities between the chloroplast and also mitochondria and also bacteria. Bacteria actually which are the primitive organisms which are evolved in the universe. Such primitive organism converted into the photosynthetically organism, active organism and also they performing the aerobic respirations. Those cells that enter into the eukaryotic cells that form finals into the final eukaryotic cell. This is the endosymbiotic theory. Okay, is it right? Now, we have to see the similarities which are present in between these three organisms like bacteria, chloroplast and mitochondria. The bacteria, chloroplast and mitochondria. Let us see the bacteria that contains the 70S ribosome. Chloroplast also contains 70S, this is also contains 70S ribosome. Actually, these two are the organelles which are present in the eukaryotic cell. But they are showing the similarities with the prokaryotic bacteria. Okay, now electron transport system. Electron transport system can occur in the membrane structure. Membrane structure, here also the membrane structure that showing the electron transport system and also here electron transport system required proteins which are present in the membrane. So this is the similarity. Along with this, DNA that is present in as a double stranded circular DNA, Double stranded circular DNA. Chloroplast also has double stranded circular DNA. The mitochondria also contains a double stranded circular DNA. Is it right? Okay. This is the major important similarities which are present among the bacteria, chloroplast and mitochondria. So that's why endosymbiotic theory, which is revealing the evolutionary relationship between the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. This is all about the chloroplast and its relation with the some other organelles like mitochondria and some other organ that is a bacteria. Okay, is it clear? So, in the next class, I will discuss the complete function of chloroplast, especially that is majorly photosynthesis. I hope it is a very clear to understand. If you really like this video, please do subscribe my channel HSR Bioinfo. Don't forget to like, comment and share. Thank you.